bit of a conundrum for him. He's had good moments here, he's had bad moments here over this weekend, but he is starting from the middle of the fourth row of the grid. Three Grand Prix wins this season, a good record here in Assen, a couple of wins, a 1-2-5 and Moto3 victories for Vinales, but the pressure is on him from the last two results in Mugello and Barcelona.
Yeah, just 7 points clear of Andrejevic, Joso, Maverick Vinales. Sounds like the factory Yamaha men will be going for the hard rear tyre. Lynn Jarvis telling Dylan that they can't make the medium last over the distance without some severe wear. Dylan?
Well, someone who's going with the soft tyre front and rear is Johan Zarco, and I'm down here with Hervé Poncharal. Hervé, you just had a last word with Johan there, I think. What words of encouragement did you give him?
I'm not going to tell you. This is a secret in between him and me. No, you know, I think for sure it's a great feeling to win pole position. It's a great feeling to, you know, have done the weekend we've done so far. But, you know, doesn't mean so much to be on pole, especially after such a few laps on the dry. You could see that tyres option are almost, you know, from softest to hardest. The two factory guys, Yamaha, are hard rear, full hard rear. We are soft. We don't know. There will be a lot of things to be discovered because, as I said earlier, not so many laps on the dry. The temperature is now rising. The sun is almost out. Honestly, I don't know what to say. The only thing I can tell you, it's going to be a great race, big battle. We could see some, you know, riders fast in the beginning, getting slower, opposite, you know, a bit slow start and catching in the end. The only thing we hope is, you know, the weather is going to stay dry and everybody will have a safe race.
Hey, Hervé, thanks a lot.
Yeah, well, Hervé Poncharal doesn't know either, does he? I don't think anybody knows what's going to happen in this race. What makes it such a great race? Aleix Espargaró, of course, on the Aprilia, out-qualified by his teammate Sam Lowes. That's the first time that's happened this season. He's had a very, very difficult time since he arrived at Aprilia, isn't he, Aleix Espargaró? He is a former pole setter here.
There's Andrea Iannone with a lot of work to do from 16th place on the grid. Still having difficulties getting accustomed to that factory Suzuki GSX RR, Dylan.
Yeah, guys, I'm just down here on the grid for one more. Someone who had an extremely impressive qualifying yesterday, Sam Lowe. Sam, so much talk, so much speculation. You kind of proved them wrong yesterday. Can you do the same in the race?
Yeah, I feel good. I think that, of course, a full dry race with not many laps is difficult for everybody. We need to pick the pace up a little bit in the dry, but Friday was quite good, so I'm looking forward to trying to get a good start, hang in there and have my best race of the season.
And you've gone soft, is that correct?
For me, it's the only tyre I did more than five laps on Friday, so it's really the only option we have.
Okay, thanks a lot, Sam, good luck.
Yeah, Sam Lowes is absolutely flying, and he's still qualified in 10th place on the fourth row of the grid when the engine blew up right in front of Valentino Rossi. But he really looked in good nick, did Sam Lowes. As did Carol Abraham for much of the weekend. In the end, qualifying wasn't so good, and he starts from 18th place.
Yeah, Hervé Poncharal's point was great. Nobody has done anywhere near full race distance on a set of slick tyres, so it really is going to be a big gamble. Who's made the right choice? That's going to be the key thing. There is Pol Espargaró on the factory KTM RC16, the 25-year-old Spaniard. His best finish in Assen, a third in 2010 on the 125s. He won, of course, from pole position in Moto2. And you've got to go all the way back to 21st on the grid to see Jorge Lorenzo. We haven't been that far back on the grid to see Lorenzo since the Spanish Grand Prix at Jerez in 2003. Gives you an indication of just what a nightmare qualifying it was for Lorenzo yesterday.
Yeah, and so disappointing after that a result in Barcelona. He rode quite brilliantly to finish in fourth place. Well, it's been one hell of a season so far. We really don't know what is going to happen today, but just what has happened so far, it should be a cracking race.
Let battle come ahead. Vinales wins here in Qatar.
Argentina.
Marcus is cracked.
Vinales wins.
Austin. 5 out of 5 here in Texas. Sit back and enjoy the race. And the winner, Danny Pedrosa.
Rossi is through to take the lead.
Rossi's
won. Rossi's down.
Vinales wins his third Grand Prix of the season. Dovizioso wins the Italian Grand Prix.
It's a dream for every Italian rider.
Barcelona, we're underway. Tremendous battle.
Marquez on the inside of Pedrosa.
Hair picking counter.
Dovizioso in dreamland.
Two in a row being championship contender.
Well, Well, that's it up to now. Round 8 of the MotoGP World Championship. 26 laps of this legendary Assen circuit. And a new man in pole position. Prepare for what could be the race of the season.
Interesting tyre choices on that second row. Rossi on the hard rear, Redding on the medium rear, and Folger on the soft rear. Bit of a mix-up as well on the front row. Zarco going soft and soft.
So here is the front row of the grid for this 8th round of the World Championship. Danilo Petrucci, the world champion Marc Marquez, and for the first time ever, Moto2 world champion Johann Zarco on pole. So a warm welcome back to Assen. I'm Nick Harris, alongside me Matt Burt. Down in pit lane, Dylan Gray. What a lineup.
Johann Zarco on pole, the first Frenchman to do so since 2002. Marquez and Petrucci on the front row with him. Rossi, Redding and Jonas Folger, a career best 6 for the German, completes row 2.
Row 3, Alvaro Bautista, Cal Crutchlow and the man in form, Andrea Dovizioso. Row 4, Sam Lowes, Maverick Vinales, the championship leader, and Danny Pedrosa.
2016 Assen winner Jack Miller heads row 5 in 13th, clear of Loris Baz and Aleix Espargaró. Iannone Rins, the two Suzuki men, joined by Carol Abraham on row 5. Row 7, Paul Espargaró, Hector Barbera and Jorge Lorenzo, his worst qualifying in 14 years. Row 8, Bradley Smith and Tito Rabat.
A final look out of the window. We will have a quick word with Dylan when they go out on this final sighting lap. We're ready to go. They started racing here in 1925. In 1949, Dutch TT stages its first World Championship race, and it is the only circuit left from that original World Championship schedule. And the usual question has been at this stage in all those years, and now we're going to have to Dylan to ask him, how's the weather?
At the moment, it's fine, Nick. It looks threatening. It's not spitting, it's not raining, so that's positive. We've just got to keep our fingers crossed, because as we know here, things can change so, so quickly. What is going to be interesting, and I think this is what Hervé Poncharal told us on the grid, with all those different tyre choices, don't be surprised to see some people quicker at the start of the race and drop off, or maybe some people start a little bit more sluggish and then gain towards the end. So that certainly will be extremely interesting.
Going to be a very interesting encounter. Aleix Espargaró has been on pole position, as I said, on the forward racing Yamaha. Has also been on the front row, second fastest on the Suzuki.
We know what
difficult one to call, Matt, this, isn't it?
We know what an aggressive starter Johann Zarco is as well, and with that soft combination front and rear, you know, if he can open up a bit of a buffer early on, he might try and make an early break with those around him on the front row, both on the medium. 105,000 fans then crammed into this Assen circuit for the Dutch showdown here. There's the championship standings before we head into round 8. Vinales, a slender 7-point lead over Andrea Dovizioso, chasing a third win for the first time in his career. Just 28 points covering the top 5 riders. That's the smallest gap covering the top 5 after 7 races since the point scoring system began in 1994. It's never been closer in that period of time at this stage of the season between the fastest 5 in the world. And let's not forget, Johann Zarco's not too far adrift in 6th place in the World Championship.
The first Frenchman in pole position in MotoGP since 2002, Olivier Jacques. The grid forms up. 23 riders will contest the 8th round of the MotoGP World Championship at this legendary Assen venue. Red flag has been taken away. Johann Zarco on pole.
Zarco got away well, but Marc Marquez got the dream start from the middle of that front row. Surely it will be Marquez that will get the whole shot. Zarco, though, holds firm, leaves his braking really late. Rossi's up into third place from fourth, running up into fourth as well. Zarco, though, briefly passed by Marquez on the run down the first corner. The Frenchman leads.
Zarco where he wants to be with a softer combination tyres. Good start by Valentino Rossi up into third place. They come into the Struben corner for the first time and then they explode like a cork out of the bottle down through the beam slang.
Jonas Folger has had a bit of a nightmare start. He started from a career best six on that second row, but he's been pushed all the way back. Cal Crutchlow's got ahead of him. Folger's lost three places back into ninth. Andrea Giannone and Jonas Folger goes running off. That's down out to the Wienschlang. So Jonas Folger's start has been a disastrous one here. Andrea Giannone's had a great start. He's up from 16th to 10th. Zarco on that soft front, soft Michelin rear tyre, already starts to break away from Marquez and the chasing pack.
That was the plan and that is exactly what has happened. Maverick Vinales trying to make up ground, trying to get past Dani Pedrosa. They really are on the wrong place in the field at the moment. We're half a lap in here at Assen. And Zarco is making a big, big move at the front.
Well, he's got the grip. He's got the advantage at this stage of the race with the soft, soft combination. The key will be, at this pace, how much longer can he run it? Pretty cool conditions out there in Assen. So you think, from what we've seen from him so far this year in the hot weather, he shouldn't have too much troubles keeping that good grip all the way through to the 26-lap finish.
Through the chicane for the very first time. They cross the line. What will Zarco's advantage be at the front? It is 6 tenths of a second over Marquez, Rossi, Petrucci, Redding, Battista, Vizioso, Crutchlow, Giannone and Vinales. That is your top 10.
Yeah, Scott Redding picked off Alvaro Bautista to take that sixth place back. No big progress made as yet by Andrea Dovizioso. He's up into seventh. Of course, the winner in Mugello and in Barcelona. We're on board now with Dovizioso. This is down into Struben, turn number five. He's got two GP16s ahead of him, Bautista and Redding.
Down through the bean slang they come. There you are. There is Battista. There is Dovizioso. Trying to get past Alvaro Battista. Not able to do so. They then come down towards the Rustenhook. This is where we saw Jonas Folger run on the previous lap. His teammate having no such problems.
Yeah.
He's increasing that lead at the front. But I think you've got to be patient, haven't you, if you're in the chasing pack, because you know probably those softer option tyres are going to start degrading before the end of the race.
Well, that's what the chasing pack hope. It's down to Johan Zarco's riding style and his tyre management. In Moto2, he was absolutely awesome at tyre management. In MotoGP, that's been one of his real strong assets. Jonas Folger had a shocker from that sixth place on the grid. That runoff at the Rustenhook dropped him all the way down to last place, 23rd.
Valentino Rossi with Danilo Petrucci behind him. Legs go out. And Dovizioso now has Cal Crutchlow right behind him. They must have got past Alvaro Battista.
So quickest man on track last time around was Marc Marquez in second place at 1:35.001. Just about a tenth and a half quicker than Johan Zarco. Redding and Bautista are having a real joust for fifth place.
I couldn't see Battista because he'd actually got past Scott Redding, hadn't he?
So Marquez just a fraction faster last time around than Johan Zarco. The top four really holding station at the moment. It's the battle going on behind them that's not really helping those guys. As long as they keep overtaking each other, they're going to be losing contact with Danilo Petrucci, currently in fourth place. Of course, Petrucci was fourth in Barcelona when he crashed out very late on a couple of weeks ago.
Vinales in 10th place. Jorge Lorenzo up to 17th spot. Dani Pedrosa dropping down now to 13th. Alessio Spargo and Jack Miller move up a place. Sam Lowes drops a place down to 15th. We ride with the leader. We ride with the man in pole position. But he's already coming under pressure from two very experienced men behind him in the shape of Marc Marquez and Valentino Rossi and Danilo Petrucci right in there as well.
Hervé Poncharal already taking big gulps of water. Dry mouth already for the team boss. He won't have many fingernails left by the end of this race as well if Johan Zarco continues his charge to what would be a magnificent career first MotoGP win. He took a win from pole here in Moto2 a couple of years ago. He's going to lead at the end of lap three here in Assen through the Timmer chicane for the third time. He's got Marc Marquez leading in hot pursuit. We're on board with the Spanish rider now as they charge over the finish line to start lap number four. Rossi now the quickest man on track with a 1:34.752.
Great ride by Alvaro Battista. As you can see, he is now in front of Scott Redding. And Dovizioso behind them. Crutchlow and Vinales battling on just behind. Miller, Aleix Espargaró, Pedrosa, Baz, Lowes is your top 15.
Yeah, Vinales knew he had to be aggressive at the start of the race, but he's only picked up one spot so far. He's down in 10th place, still the world championship leader. Andrea Iannone's having a really strong ride. He started 16th, but he's just on the last lap picked off Cal Crutchlow. So Iannone really baring his teeth for the first time this year. And that's Suzuki up there in 8th place already for the first time. Oh, was that Marquez? Look at that. He was almost down there, Marquez. Was that big front end slide from the reigning world champion?
They are absolutely determined. They're not going to let Zarco break them up at the front, and he's not been able to do it. And the three riders behind, I was going to say they look comfortable. They are having to ride very, very hard to stay with Zarco, but tyre choice suggests that they are very nicely placed. This is riding with Valentino Rossi. You can see Marc Marquez and Zarco in front of him.
Yeah, the theory, which of course has been thrown out of the window quite a few times this year, is with that hard tyre on the rear of that Yamaha, Rossi should have maybe a little bit more life, a little bit more endurance for the final third of the race. We'll find out how it pans out. It's going to be intriguing because Zarco's got the soft rear tyre, and Marquez has got the medium, and Rossi's got the hard option on the rear as well. So it's going to be an intriguing tyre battle as well as a personal duel between the three of them.
This is a cracking race for fifth place. Scott Redding now is back in fifth place in front of Alvaro Bautista. We can see Iannone and Dovizioso just behind him.
Iannone's just put in the fastest lap of the race. Credit to him. He's come up for some fierce criticism for some underwhelming performances on that Suzuki. We saw him fight for the podium in Qatar on his Suzuki debut when he crashed out while battling with Marc Marquez. That's the best we've seen from Iannone since the opening night at LaSalle International Circuit.
Dovizioso is thinking, I've really got to get out of this battle. Oh, Iannone up the inside of Dovizioso. He gave him half an inch and he came through. That's the old Andrea Iannone.
And he would have loved that move, putting up the inside of his old teammate on the factory Ducati. He's got the red mist down here, Andrea Iannone. Next in his sights is Scott Redding. So Andrea Iannone, we said at the start of the programme, not only top six on that Suzuki so far for him this year, but he's got one in his sights now.
Vinales now up in ninth place in front of Cal Crutchlow, so he is just picking up a few more points. As far as the championship goes, Dovizioso can finish in front of Vinales. He will close the gap on the man at the front.
Yeah, Vinales has finally found his way through on Cal Crutchlow, so Vinales up to ninth.
We switch back to Valentino Rossi coming into the S's. Yeah, that is Marc Marquez in front of him. No, they're okay this time around. Remember 2 years ago. They're over the start finish line. There's a long, long way to go yet. 21 laps to go for 26 lap race. These very are much the early stages into the harbour. And then this succession of right-handers. We ride with the 9 times winner here in Hassan, Valentino Rossi.
Danilo Petrucci just fired in his personal best lap of the race. He's fighting hard to stay in that podium battle. 1:34.766 from the Italian, just about a tenth faster than the three riders in front of him. What a battle that's raging here at fourth, fifth place. Scott Redding's got a bit of daylight between himself, you know, Dovizioso, Bautista, Vinales, Crutchlow and Miller. That's a right old dogfight going on for the top six.
It could be an absolutely crucial race for fifth place as it stands at the moment. When we go to Valencia in that final round of the World Championship, there's some really important World Championship points up for stake. And the men who are first and second in the championship, Dovizioso and Vinales.
And two riders who are really, really struggling. Dani Pedrosa's way down in 13th place. Jorge Lorenzo still not been able to find himself into the point scoring places. Lorenzo currently circulating way, way down in 16th.
So look at Jack Miller currently running in 11th place. Right at just at the end of this battle. Let me have a Lacia Spargano. We've just got a glimpse there of Dani Pedrosa. Yeah, difficult weekend for Pedrosa. He's been in such good form.
It's pretty much as you were, isn't it, in terms of the gap between those top four. A concertina up, the effect of the brakes going into the Timber chicane then. Start of lap number six. Zarco from Marquez, Rossi and Petrucci, that's your top four. Scott Redding has just fired in a 1:34.617. The fastest lap of the race as Redding tries to break away from the chasing pack led by Iannone, from Dovizioso, Bautista, Vinales and Crutchlow. This is really impressive by Scott Redding.
Yeah, he certainly has broken away from Iannone. We ride back with Valentino Rossi. This is the four riders in the lead through the Struben corner down towards the Wienerschlange. As you were, you're absolutely right about that. This is like a firework waiting to explode big time, and it is going to explode. probably be a few laps more before it really starts getting tasty.
Still 20 laps to go. Awfully long way. Scott Redding there. We know that Scott really, really has massive issues in extremely hot conditions. So these cool temperatures will be suiting him down to the ground. Jorge Lorenzo then has finally found himself up into the point scoring place. His last time around, he took Sam Lowes and Loris Paz. So Lorenzo up into 14th place, but he's 3.7 seconds behind Danny Pedrosa in 13th.
This is where he would want to be. Zarco still leads the way. Momentarily into turn one off the start line, we saw Marc Marquez lead the way, but Zarco made his intentions very clear. He took the lead, he opened up a bit of a gap, but the trio have caught him. But at the moment, they're quite happy to just sit there and wait. Though I thought Valentino Rossi had a little think about getting up the inside of Marquez there.
You have to give more kudos and take your hat off again to Danilo Petrucci. The last three Grand Prix, he has been right there fighting for the podium. He did it, did the business in Mugello to score his first dry race MotoGP podium. He was fourth before he crashed out late on in Barcelona, and there he is again in fourth place, right on the exhaust pipes of Valentino Rossi.
We ride with Valentino Rossi. That has really concertinaed up now, hasn't it, as they come down towards the Veenslag. 18 and a half laps to go, round 8 of the MotoGP World Championship. We're in Attern. Will Hartog looks on after winning that race 40 years ago. I bet he's thinking, oh, I wish it was 40 years ago and I could be involved in a race like this.
This could be a ride-saving ride by Scott Redding, the way he's going. He's riding for his future. Lots of rumours about whether Pramac Ducati are considering other options. Well, we know they are. They've been talking to Jack Miller. They've been talking to Franco Morbidelli. And Scott Redding needs a big, big result to try and put himself in that shop window, try and convince Pramac that he was the man to keep. Well, fifth place in the Dutch TT will do his chances the world of good.
I tell you, everybody, and I mean everybody, I think in the crowd of 105,000, are just waiting for this explosion to come.
Yeah, Marquez and Rossi look really strong in that fourth sector.
They look comfortable, don't they? Yeah, Marquez made one, coming into the chicane, but apart from that, they look very comfortable indeed. As does Zarco at the front of him, to be honest with you.
But it's edge grip you need through those fast changes of direction. And, you know, with Zarco, you just wonder whether, you know, he might be just running out of a little bit of edge grip with that soft option rear tyre on.
Ross has had a couple of looks at Marc Marquez, and without making any sort of move up at turn one and at the chicane. Finger biting time back in the garages. There is Scott Redding. Dovizioso is. Trouble is, Scott Dovizioso is bringing along a few friends with him, isn't he? And that does include now Maverick Viñales.
Yeah, Scott Redding's early charge. How much has he burned up that rear tyre? We know he's on that medium rear tyre. He said that was the only option he felt he could go for. Didn't do enough laps on the hard to run that. Scott Redding is coming under real pressure here from that chasing group. Redding currently running in fifth place, but has he just abused that rear tyre too much to try and make that break at the start of this race? There's still a long way to go, but Dovizioso and Viñales started to really pile on the pressure now.
Yeah, as far as the championship goes, if Viñales could finish in front of Dovizioso and be fourth or fifth in this race, I don't think it would be, he'd feel it was a bad afternoon's work, do you?
Something happened to Andrea, you know, he did it last time around, because Shinoni was right at the front of this group. He did a 1:36.2, so whether he had a runoff somewhere, you know, because he lost a whole bunch of places on that lap number 8.
They've lit the blue touch paper and it's running along at the moment. One of those things before the big explosion.
Yeah, I think it's just coming to the boil nicely, isn't it? Oh, Sam Lowes has crashed out. Sam Lowes was running in 15th place. He started in a MotoGP best qualifying of 10th. So Sam Lowes, that's frustration you can see there written all over his face. He knew that was an opportunity to score points for only the second time in his MotoGP career. The last thing he needed when he's riding for his future, of course, so much speculation that Aprilia are pondering and contemplating replacing him alongside Aleix Espargaró next year.
At the front, Valentino Rossi still in third place. Zarco, Marquez,
Olga's crashed as well.
Oh, Jonas Folger's had an absolute disaster. Ran wide on the very first lap down at the Ruskin Hook.
So that's it. There's no rider now in MotoGP that scored points in every race. Jonas Folger was the last one. The first race error we've seen of the year from the German. Not the way he would have wanted to have been going back home to the Saxon ring next week. Vinales has got pace now, hasn't he? He's got into his rhythm.
He
looks like he'll be able to ease his way through on Scott Redding very, very quickly.
And Dovizioso will really want to go with him. And I've got to say, Alvaro Bautista on that GP16 is quick. And he's quite capable to stand with these guys who stand at the moment. Redding coming under real pressure. Dovizioso thinks about getting on the inside of Vinales. Decides perhaps not the thing to do.
I don't think Vinales is going to be quick enough to attack at the tip of chicane. No, he's not. Bautista, though, was close enough to attack Dovizioso. Classic and clinical tip of chicane move there on the brakes by Bautista. Executed to absolute perfection. So Bautista back up into seventh place. Rossi through on Marquez. That's down at the first corner. So Rossi then makes his move towards the front. Rossi up to second.
Yeah, he lined him up a couple of laps ago, did Valentino Rossi. 38 years old. And still loving every minute of it. Marquez quite happy to sit there in third place. Petrucci looking strong. Let's have a look. Here they come into turn one on the brakes. They left a big enough gap, and Rossi's not going to say, "I'm going to wait my turn," is he, when that happens?
So Yamaha 1-2 then. Johann Zarco, the rookie sensation, still leading. Marquez led briefly off the line. Zarco, though, did get the whole shot, and that's where he's been at the front of this race right from the get-go. But he's under real pressure from Rossi. He's been ice cool so far, though, Zarco. He has not put one foot wrong in the first 10.5 laps here in Assen.
We ride with Rossi, Marquez right in his face. We switch back now to Marquez. Rossi right in his face as well. Rossi moved into second place. The first move of the top four for a long, long time. Zarco trying to break them up at the front. That hasn't worked. So we'll just see what Zarco's got. We know what Zarco has got. He will fight aggressively to hang in there.
I just wonder whether Marquez was going to have another lunge at Rossi at the tip of chicane, a la 2015. Not yet. It might be coming a little bit later on in the race.
15 laps ago, another classic encounter here.
Rossi's going for it.
Rossi's in the lead. Rossi at turn one. He did it on the previous lap against Marquez, he's done it again. Valentino Rossi leads here in Assen.
The majority of the 105,000 fans packed here into... Oh, there's a touch there. Zarco on the inside through turn number four. Definite contact between Zarco and Rossi. Rossi was really fortunate. The second time this year that there's been contact between Zarco and Rossi. Cast your minds back to the Circuit of the Americas in Austin, Texas. Not sure there was any way through there for Johann Zarco. Big, big contact between the two Yamaha men.
And almost contact between Petrucci and Zarco after that incident. Right, let's have a look at it.
Yeah, Rossi's running a wider line. Zarco, Rossi just ran the wide line. You can see there the contact lifted Rossi's foot off the left foot peg. Now we know Johann Zarco, if he sees a gap that's an inch wide, he's going to take it. He's not sure when it comes to aggressive overtakes. Fortunate that it was not more dire consequences for the pair of them there.
It has ignited now, hasn't it? This is it. We ride with Valentino Rossi. We ride now with Marc Marquez in second place.
You've got to love Zarco, though. He was doing a Rossi there. Once you pass Rossi, you know, when Rossi gets overtaken, he fights straight back at the next corner. And that's what Zarco was trying to do. There's nothing wrong with his aggression and his bravery and his courage.
Here they come into the chicane. Rossi leads the way. Marquez right behind him. Then Zarco, then Petrucci. 14 crucial laps to go.
Yellow flags are waving there at the final chicane. Vinales has crashed. The world championship leader, Maverick Vinales, has crashed out. We saw the yellow flags. That is a disaster for Maverick Vinales. We potentially could have a new world championship leader heading to the German Grand Prix in the Saxon ring. Nightmare for Vinales.
Down he goes, coming out of the chicane. Left-hander loses the front end, and his championship lead almost certainly will disappear. We ride with him.
Timo Chicane, he just got to the front of that second group. On the gas, dear me, Andrea Dovizioso did well there to avoid Maverick Vinales. Andrea Dovizioso then, well, how's the championship going to shape up now? Vinales absolutely dejected. He'd done so much of the hard work to get himself up into fifth place. And there he is, down at the Timo Chicane, second DNF of the year now. for Maverick Vinales. If Rossi wins this race, Rossi's going to be 3 points behind his teammate in the championship.
Meanwhile, at the front, two old friends are meeting up and they are ready for the fight of all fights.
Dear me, I've got to say, there was no room there for Zarco. Massive whack on the left shoulder. Valentino Rossi has got a big black mark on that right shoulder. Rossi was running a wide line, no doubt about it, but he was cutting it back to the apex when he got a, I wouldn't say a friendly tap from Johann Zarco. I don't think anything happens at this speed in MotoGP that's very friendly. Zarco's actually now dropped back behind Danilo Petrucci on this lap. So Zarco back and forth. Has he made a mistake or is he just running out of a bit of a grip? Straight away, Marquez gets the Vinales out on his pit board. Massive, massive moment in the 2017 World Championship.
And there he is. He may be the championship leader until the end of this race, but it does appear for the first time this season, Maverick Vinales will not be leading the title chase going into the halfway stage, the race 9 at the Sachsenring in Germany next weekend. Bitter disappointment for the 22-year-old. Confirmation of where it stands at the moment.
Wow, look at that. We could be going to the Sachsenring. If you threw the checkered flag now, we would have four riders split by just 7 points. And Andrea Dovizioso on the factory Ducati leading the MotoGP World Championship. That could all change, of course, with this fantastic fight raging now between Rossi and Marc Marquez. It looks like Johann Zarco might be struggling to hang on in there with him running out of grip with those soft tyres. Vinales, very disconsolate, walks straight out of the factory Yamaha garage. It's game over for him, and he knows potentially he's going to surrender the World Championship lead.
With Vinales out, these two have got to be careful, haven't they, Rossi and Marquez? They've got to forget old battle. They've got to finish this race because it will make the championship so much closer. But I don't even think they'll be thinking about the World Championship.
I tell you what, they won't be forgetting old battles. They'll be remembering old battles in this one. Especially 2 years ago, right here on the very last lap. We've been here before. Deja vu, ladies and gentlemen. A factory Yamaha with Valentino Rossi and a Repsol Honda with Marc Marquez in close pursuit. Rossi goes for a tear off on the start-finish straight. He leads the Dutch TT there by just over a tenth from Marquez. Dovizioso and Crutchlow have just set personal best laps. Bradley Smith has crashed out of the race on the factory KTM. Smith was circulating in 20th place.
We ride with Marc Marquez. Valentino Rossi in front of him. He did win the race here 2 years ago. Well, was it controversial? It depends which side of the story you hear, but it was against Marc Marquez. The big, big news though from Assen, championship leader Maverick Vinales has crashed out. And if Andrea Dovizioso stays where he is in fifth place, he will be the new leader of the World Championship riding the Ducati. But there's still 11 and a half laps to go.
Yeah. And everybody keeps looking skywards. Will the rain play some kind of pivotal role in this race? We certainly hope not, because we've got an absolutely corking MotoGP race here in Assen. Bradley Smith crashed in at turn number 7. Let's hope that he's not aggravated some of the damage to that badly mangled left little finger that kept him out of the Barcelona race a couple of weeks ago. There is Petrucci then, heading forward.
We've
would be his second
him,
podium
telling
in the last three races. And he's right there. He is absolutely right in the victory contention.
Yeah, pulls right up on the rear wheel there of Marc Marquez. Third, of course, in Mugello, right in contention in Barcelona. Zarco's not out of it yet. We've seen this before from Zarco. Covered his composure a little bit. Over the line. 11 laps to go here in Assen. The Yellow Army can't believe it, because their man leads the way. But there's a lot more of this race to go.
Last time around, Zarco was the only one of the top four in the 134s. He was about 0.3 seconds quicker than Marquez and Petrucci right in front of him. Danilo Petrucci is going to be close to him. He's going for it. That's Ruben, turn number 5. Petrucci, I was just about to say he's lining up a move on Marquez, and he does it at the very next corner. Petrucci up in the second place.
Well, it's his great friend, Valentino Rossi. He'll probably say to him, thank you very much indeed. Petrucci, would he dare challenge Rossi for the lead? And Rossi is just prizing open a little bit of an advantage at the front.
You've got to feel Rossi is the only one of this lead group that's got the hard rear tyre on. That could be absolutely crucial, could be a decisive choice, because in theory, the theory has been blown out of the window a few times this year in MotoGP, then Rossi in the final laps of the race should have the better rear grip. That rear tyre should have held together better.
Yeah, they're telling him now that it's Danilo Petrucci in second place. 10.5 laps to go. This is Petrucci. As I say, third in Mugello. First dry weather podium finish. Two front row starts in Barcelona and here. Really going well at Barcelona before he crashed out. Rossi into the chicane. What a famous victory this would be for the 38-year-old. 10 laps to go.
Would be a massive win for the championship. Rossi came into this Dutch TT 28 points behind his teammate Vinales. Vinales is already in the shower. He's having an early bath after that crash at the tip of chicane. Danilo Petrucci, has he come of age in 2017? What a series of performances by Petrucci. Dovizioso then, what's the gap to Dovizioso and Zarco? 2.3 seconds. Dovizioso last time around though was 0.8 of a second quicker than the Monster Yamaha Tech 3 man. He's got 10 laps to go. Dovizioso might be more crucial World Championship points at stake for the Italian. Has he got time to hunt down this man Zarco?
Here is Zarco coming down through the Veenslang, coming down towards Rustenhoek. And further down towards the right-hander, Steckenwald.
Rossi's trying to check out here, isn't he?
He's trying to go.
He's got the lead now for the first time in this race. With what? 9.5 laps remaining. He's up to over a second for the first time. Rossi looking pretty confident, looking pretty comfortable. He did lead, of course, on the final lap in Le Mans when he buckled under intense pressure from his teammate Maverick Vinales. Can he streak away? Leave nothing to chance, leave nothing to doubt this time around.
But it does appear at the moment that Marquez can do nothing about it.
No.
Marquez knows he's clearing him off and also knows that he's having problems getting past Danilo Petrucci. Again, he knows as well that Maverick Vinales is out of the race, so he doesn't want to take too many risks.
Rossi now will just be praying that he doesn't start seeing spots of rain on his visor, because he's in complete control of this Dutch TT now. As Rossi comes over the line, last time around he was almost half a second quicker than Petrucci in second place.
What's the Dovizioso's charging? Dovizioso's
come down to 1.7 seconds. Last time around, Dovizioso was 0.6 of a second faster than the Frenchman.
Right, let's quickly run through what is happening in 9 laps ago. Rossi, Petrucci, Marquez, Zarco, Dovizioso, Bautista, Crutchlow, Aleix Espargaró, Danny Pedrosa and Jack Miller top then. Redding dropping down now in 11th place. Iannone, Lorenzo, Baz Abraham, Rins Barbara, Espargaró, Pol and Tito Rabat. We've had crashes for Bradley Smith, Maverick Vinales, Jonas Folger and Sam Lowes.
Oh, Álvaro Bautista's gone down. Bautista was running in a really strong 6th place. Lightning strikes twice for the Spaniard. He was running 6th on the last lap here last year when he crashed out, just in front of Cal Crutchlow. That's at Struben, turn number 5 for Bautista. So another top 6 slips through the grasp of the Spaniard. That's pushed, Jorge Lorenzo up to 12th. Danny Pedrosa up to 8th place now.
This is the battle for 2nd place. Marquez behind Danilo Petrucci. Zarco not quite up, but closing all the time. You can see him closing. It's Andrea Dovizioso.
Really sorry to have butt in, Nick. We are getting a few minute little drops down here in pit
lane. No.
No, it's if it stays like this, it's okay to race. If it's okay, if it stays like this, they should be okay. If it gets any stronger, we should have rain flags come out. Yes, we've got the white flag. Flag to flag ready.
Deary me, the white flag is displayed. So the pit lane is open then for the riders, should they desire to come in and change bikes. There is late, late drama here. What a potential sting in the tail here. You are now allowed to pull it.
Dovizioso is...
You can see quite clearly there are spots of rain on our camera lens there at turn number 3.
All teams now out. Every single second bike is already ready for the win.
Can it get any more dramatic here in Assen? The rain started to fall.
You just could not write this script, could you? You could not write this script. There is Dovizioso getting past Zarco. Zarco is really struggling now. Dovizioso now is leading.
Dovizioso through on Marquez. Dovizioso now has come through on Marquez. Dovizioso could still win this Grand Prix. Can he make it 3 in a row? What a hat-trick this would be for Andrea Dovizioso. He's on the podium places.
7.5 laps to go. MotoGP, it just brings the biggest surprises, the biggest shocks that you could ever believe. Dovizioso now on the charge. He knows Vinales is out. He doesn't want to take too many
risks. Look at Petrucci.
Oh, Petrucci's coming right up on the rear wheel now. Valentino Rossi.
You see, the issue for Rossi is he's hitting the rain spots first, so Rossi's going to be more cautious than those behind him. Petrucci's using Rossi as a great reference. Petrucci's about to take Valentino Rossi to lead here in Aston Dillon.
Yes, of course, we were told the operating temperature of that harder option rear is around 29 degrees.
Zarco's come in. Dylan, Zarco's come in. Zarco's entered the pits. Now, has he gambled and rolled the dice, or has he got a problem? But Zarco has come in.
Zarco first, man.
Yeah, he's changing.
Here.
He's changing.
Yeah, back out.
Now, is that a tactical masterstroke of a genius, or... He's got nothing to lose, has he?
No.
He's got absolutely nothing to lose.
Right, back at the front, Rossi under real pressure now from Danilo Petrucci. Andrea Dovizioso also in the hunt, as you can see. Marc Marquez 4, Zarco in, Crutchlow now moves up to 5th place.
Guys, Hector Barbera also come in for a bike change.
Right, Zarco now needs a deluge. He needs the heavens to open now he's gone out on those rain tyres. Back at the front still, Rossi. By a whisker from Petrucci, Dovizioso, who was miles back a few laps ago, has suddenly come into contention for his third win in a row.
Rossi coming under pressure. Rossi still leading the way. The two Italians behind him on a Ducati. So it's Italians 1, 2, 3, but it's Yamaha, Ducati, Ducati. Got the feeling that Petrucci wants to make a move because he knows that Dovizioso is coming like a train behind him. But Rossi will not give up the lead that easily. We switch back now to ride with Valentino Rossi. That number 9 in his face. Dovizioso now closing up. Dovizioso up the inside of Petrucci. Dovizioso moves into second place in the chicane.
Dovizioso's looking so, so strong. Valentino Rossi leads in at the start of lap 21. An all-Italian top three at the moment. Marc Marquez is not being shaken off. Cal Crutchlow's over the line in fifth. Petrucci out a little bit wide at the first corner. That allows Marquez to close up. But Dovizioso now, he's thrown down the gauntlet to Valentino Rossi. It looks like the most rainfall is falling around turn three in that first sector. Zarco's taken a massive, massive gamble here. He was running in fourth place in the race. Petrucci fights straight back on Dovizioso at turn number five. Safely through at Struben. Petrucci back in his second place. Alex Rins has come into the pits for a bike. Swap.
Almost side by side, they race the two Ducatis down the Veenslang.
Lorenzo's in as well.
Rossi still out advantage. Rossi, I'm sorry, Lorenzo in.
He's coming in for his bike swap. Those guys now need it to absolutely pour down with rain.
Oh, Marc Marquez is right back in this race. So, it's a Yamaha, two Ducatis and a Honda. Lorenzo back out there, Petrucci closing up. Vizioso got past him once, Petrucci fall back immediately in the left hand of the Struben corner.
Petrucci was going for it.
Quite happy there now in fourth place. We still have 5.5 laps to go.
Well, look, guys, here in pit lane, this rain has now died out. It's pretty much stopped.
Wow, Dylan.
Great news for Rossi, Petrucci, Dovizioso, Marquez. Bad news for the likes of Johan Zarco, Jorge Lorenzo, Hector Barber and Alex Rins. Petrucci, he keeps having a look up the inside of Rossi, doesn't he, at Ramchuk? He's going to have a lunge at the inside of the Timo chicane. Surely Petrucci will go up the inside. No, he can't quite find a way through. How close was that between Rossi and Petrucci? Rossi stands firm. He leads over the line to start lap 22.
105,000 people just stand up and applaud.
Dovizioso's through again.
Oh, Dovizioso through at turn one at the Harbour.
Petrucci just struggling a little bit hard on the brakes into that first corner. We saw him run wide the last
time
around.
He took him back though at the left-hander at the Struben, didn't he? Will he do it again?
Dovizioso's mechanics getting his spare bike ready. That'll be fitted with those Michelin rain tyres.
Not through this time, as you can see.
Still nobody though, Nick, has been able to find a way through on Rossi despite them all closing up on him. He has stood firm like a rock at the front of this race.
Down through the Veenslang. 4.75 laps to go. Here comes Dovizioso. He definitely thought about it that time round and decided no. He is lining up Rossi. But Petrucci up the inside as he lines him up. Back into second place.
Petrucci and Mendevane. What a race we've got here. This is down now at the DeBolt corner. It was a Steckenbar that Petrucci struck. Mendevane here was where Rossi crashed out of the lead in the wet conditions here 1 year ago. Oh, Petrucci, that was tight up at Mendevane. He keeps having a look up the inside of Rossi, but he can't quite make it through.
You've got to say Rossi is like a rock at the front, isn't he? He cannot be shifted. First of it, Dovizioso has to go right side by side, and he has got through.
Danilo Petrucci now leads away. Rossi in second place. They're through the round shot up to the chicane. Will Rossi try and fight back at the chicane? No, Petrucci leads. He should cross the line with four laps to go. Could he win his first Grand Prix?
Petrucci got amazing grip and drive coming out of Dukesloop. Blitz past Rossi like Rossi was on a Moto2 bike. Petrucci then leads. He led for the first time in his MotoGP career here 1 year ago. Dovizioso's out wide at turn number one. That's let Marquez sweep back through. Petrucci led in Assen last year. Didn't finish the race. He led in Germany last year. Crashed out in wet conditions. Here he now leads in Assen.
Danilo Petrucci chasing his first ever Grand Prix victory. His first ever podium finishes when he finished behind Valentino Rossi in the rain at Silverstone. We're back now with Dovizioso, who was challenging for the lead, but now is down in fourth place. It's that sort of race, and the two Italians are just opening up a bit of an advantage.
What we know now, yeah, they are. They're pulling away quite easily. Dovizioso and Marquez then, maybe just running out of steam at the end of this race. Johann Zarco's just come over the line. We know that he's on full wets. He did a 1:43 last time around. So he's about 5 seconds off of the pace. Dovizioso fighting back again on Marc Marquez. These are absolutely crucial, pivotal world championship points up for grabs here.
Down at the bottom end of the circuit through Mandeven, through the Dukesloop. Then they start this fantastic run back up towards the start and finish. Through the very, very fast Ramchok left-hander, they will come.
Well, now Rossi can use Petrucci as the reference. He's done all the legwork himself for a while, Rossi. Now it'll be Petrucci coming into some of those spots to rain first. Is Rossi going to lunge up the inside? You bet he is. You can see that one coming from a mile away. Rossi then takes the lead back at the Timmershire gate. We've got three laps to go here in Aston. It's Rossi from Petrucci.
The atmosphere at this circuit is like the World Cup final of soccer. People are going crazy. 105,000 spectators, and they are being richly entertained by the best riders in the world.
Cal Crutchlow there in fifth place, a pretty lonely fifth place, but Crutchlow actually last time around was the quickest of the top five on the circuit. Rossi and Petrucci have broken away from Dovizioso Marquez. Unless we get the rain hammering down, then surely now we've got a shootout between the great mates. Rossi and Petrucci, such great friends off the track. They won't be great mates right now.
There is Cal Crutchlow. He really has made progress up into fifth place. We ride with Marc Marquez. That is Andrea Dovizioso in front of him. It's raining again. Yep. It is raining again at the far end of the circuit.
And Johann Zarco, well, his race has had a disaster. He's got a ride through penalty. He exceeded the pit lane speed limit when he came in the change bikes. You can only run at 60 kilometres an hour, says Johann Zarco.
Can you believe it? What else can happen here? Rossi leads the way. We have 2.5 laps remaining of a truly amazing Assen TT here in Holland. Petrucci closes up right again on the rear wheel of Rossi. They're through the ramshaw. They will line up the chicane. This is where Rossi took Petrucci to take the lead on the previous lap.
Hats off to Rossi. Another DNF now would be so, so detrimental for his World Championship challenge. Dovizioso Marquez, Petrucci fighting back again. Petrucci gets that rear tyre really hooked up well on that acceleration. But Rossi's throwing everything at this. He knows that he's trying to get that crucial victory. There's so much risk over reward here for Rossi. Confirmation on your screen. Speeding in the pit lane is going to cost Johann Zarco. Don't think he's going to actually now finish inside the point scoring places.
Back at the front. Can Rossi just open up a precious advantage?
Cal Crutchlow's right in there. This could be a podium for Crutchlow. Where has he come from? Cal Crutchlow is riding quite brilliantly in these sketchy conditions. Last time around, he was 1.6 seconds faster than Dovizioso Marquez in front of him. Cal Crutchlow smelling blood here. He can smell the podium. Oh, Marquez up the inside of Dovizioso going through Rushkanhook.
Crutchlow is right there with them. This is the battle for third place. Marquez third, Dovizioso four.
Crutchlow's
the inside. He's going to get past Dovizioso. He's gone through.
He's got the inside line. Crutchlow then up into fourth place.
Crutchlow looks very capable of taking over third place.
My brain can't work quick enough. I mean, does that still mean Andrea Dovizioso leads the World Championship now? Oh. It does. Yeah, there we go. Thank you very much, guys. Yeah, thank you. Somebody's brain's working sharper than mine right now.
More than ours is at the moment. This is the battle for third place. Petrucci and Rossi still fight it out for the lead. Marquez in third. It would be a 4-point advantage for Andrea Dovizioso at the front.
Last lap on the way. Crutchlow's got to be the third. Cal Crutchlow has taken third place from Marquez at the Timber Chicane. We're on the last lap. It's a straight showdown then for the victory, surely between Rossi and Petrucci. 0.4 seconds, Rossi led over the line over Danilo Petrucci. Can Petrucci find something late on here in Assen? Can Rossi successfully defend the lead, which he couldn't do against Vinales in Le Mans? Rossi's got a pretty healthy buffer there as they come through the Struben corner. 13 corners left for Rossi, chasing what will be a 10th win here in Assen.
Marquez fights back against Cal Crutchlow. Marquez now back into third place. Dovizioso right on the rear wheel of the LCR Honda. Crucial World Championship points at stake.
Valentino Rossi then on the brink of his 115th career victory in Grand Prix. Has he finally broken the resolve of Petrucci? Crutchlow again finds himself back up into third place. Who's going to take third? Nobody can guess. This is unbelievable action. Oh, Scott Redding has crashed out on the last lap. Redding has gone down on the last lap. Here is Crutchlow then holding off Marquez. Dovizioso there's waiting to pick up the pieces. Then Rossi will be in the final sector now. The doctor, has he done it here in Assen? Here he comes then, out of turn number 11. Rossi in the final sector.
38 years old, the absolute masterclass. Surely one of the greatest motorcycle races we have ever seen as Marquez gets back past Crutchlow to take third place. His 115th Grand Prix victory. Valentino Rossi wins here in Assen.
Petrucci a fantastic second. Marquez just holds on for third place. What a fight, what a race here in Assen. A classic in front of a crowd of 105,000 fans. Marquez took third, Crutchlow fourth, Dovizioso fifth. Jack Miller will cross the line in a lonely but very, very well-earned sixth place. What a race. What an incredible 26-lap race here in Assen. Unbelievable scenes.
I've got to lie down in a darkened room for about a week now.
I'm going to still do Moto 2.
Right, Carol Aram, what a result for him in seventh place. Loris Paz 8, Andrea Iannone in 9th. But Valentino Rossi, 115 Grand Prix victories. Write him off at your peril.
Valentino Rossi for the 10th time here in Assen, victorious in front of that passionate Dutch crowd. 20 years ago in 1997 he took the first in the 125cc race. And what about that, the mouth-watering prospect heading to Germany in just 5 days' time, the top four in the World Championship split by just 11 points. Andrea Dovizioso, we forget, he's now leading the World Championship.
Oh, absolutely unbelievable Dutch TT. We've seen many a great battle around here.
Was that pivotal? Was that crucial? Petrucci coming up on Alex Rins at the Ramshut.
Just
Alex Rins would have been getting blue flags there. Is that Andrea Migno? It is. We saw that the roles reversed in Mugello where Valentino Rossi was doing the congratulations. Andrea Migno then, that's brownie points celebrating with the boss like that, isn't it? Look at that, the longest winning career in all classes. 20 years and 313 days since his first win.
What more can you say about the man? Very little. Just look at his record. Just look at the way he's record. Luca Cadalore's coach. Was former 250cc world champion and also a great 500cc Grand Prix rider. He has done it.
Danilo Petrucci, let's not forget the part that he played in an absolutely fantastic, nail-biting, thrilling, tense and dramatic encounter here in Assen. I'm going through the old thesaurus now, trying to find out some other words. Petrucci, well, that's his career best result, a second place. Oh, no, sorry, his career best in the dry, I should say.
Silverstone, he was second behind Valentino Rossi, wasn't it?
Yeah. A few years ago, he rolled in the grass. Was that for his 100th win?
I think it
was. 2013. First win then for Rossi in over a year. His first win in 19, and what a time to do it. Talk about making up for the disappointment of crashing out of the lead last year, and with his teammate Maverick Vinales crashing out of the race. another big pendulum swing in terms of the championship.
Decent old ride by Marquez, picked up some very crucial points, didn't he?
There was a stage at that Timmer chicane early on the race, Nick, where he had that massive front end slot. I don't know how he saved it, where Marc Marquez thought, oh no, I'm down the road here. How he saved that moment on the front at the Timmer chicane was quite remarkable.
Where do you start thinking about this race? I can tell you that Maverick Vinales crashed out and he doesn't lead the world championship. We have a new championship leader, Andrea.
This is it. This is the moment where Vinales' race came to a bitterly disappointing end. I tell you what, Andrea also did an incredible job of missing Maverick Vinales. There you go. Vinales on the floor and his world championship lead gone in an instant.
And it's his teammate, Valentino Rossi, who wins the race. He is now just 10 points behind
behind
Andrea Dovizioso in the lead, and Maverick Vinales sandwiched between them.
11 points, as we said, now covering Dovizioso, Vinales, Rossi and Marquez. There's Zarco. Well, he gambled. He was the first rider to come in when he saw those spots of rain, started from pole position. He thought, I've got nothing to lose, I'll come in, switch to the rain bike. Didn't pay off. The rain just didn't come as hard as he needed it to.
His day will come, Johan Zarco.
Absolutely.
No doubt about that.
Yeah.
Valentino Rossi wins in Assen for the 10th time. 20 years ago, he won the 125cc race. Well, Andrea Dovizioso will be happy to be leaving the World Championship with a big thumbs up.
Well, yeah, fifth, probably not what he wanted. Look at this, listen to this. Reception for the doctor. Yellow flares going off. There's going to be some pretty jubilant scenes very, very shortly.
The most popular man in World Championship motorsport on two or four wheels. He's 38 years old and he has just won his 115th Grand Prix.
Giacomo Agostini can start looking over his shoulder again now, can't he? Yeah, incredible. 89th win in the Premier Class for Valentino Rossi. Absolutely amazing job.
That was a masterclass, wasn't it? Absolute masterclass of the conditions, the tyre choice, just doing everything right.
It's his eighth win in the Premier Class here in MotoGP in front of the Dutch fans. And that was a massive, massive win for the championship. Absolutely crucial. Rossi right back in the hunt. 28 points he came into this race behind Vinales. He's now just 8 behind Andrea Dovizioso. The consolation prize for Dovizioso, 5th in the race, but he goes to Germany leading the World Championship. That hard option rear tyre choice, obviously crucial for Rossi. Marquez was running out of grip in those final laps on the medium. They've been there before. Ah, 1-2 Silverstone in 2015.
Yeah, that is terrific. See him and Danilo Petrucci celebrate. I think Petrucci felt he could have won that race.
Back-to-back front row starts for Petrucci. Two podiums in the last three. He is right there, isn't he? Week in, week out now, Petrucci.
Well, there's still another race to come, but they certainly have had their money's worth, the crowd of 105,000.
There's old Will Hartog down there, congratulating. He did it here 40 years ago, Will Hartog. Wow, what a race. Where do you, like you say, where do you start?
Where do you start? Well, Rossi winning, Vinales crashing out, I suppose, is the big story, but the rest, so much happened.
Rossi's winning time was 41 minutes and 41 seconds. I think the highlights will be about 39 minutes,
yeah,
won't they?
That's right, yeah. Marc Marquez, third, picked up some very, very important World Championship points. He's right in the hunt now, isn't he?
Got to be happy. Got to be happy when you think he was almost on the floor at the Timmer chicane earlier in the race, when he was in second place.
Well, absolutely superb action. Round 8 of the championship In 1 week's time, we're going to get the Saxon Ring in Germany. I think everybody needs a summer break then, don't you? I think we do.
I'm not sure Valentino would have been too happy had the roles been reversed though. He's all smiles, as is Danilo Petrucci. If Petrucci had beaten him, I know
he would have not been happy.
First win then since Barcelona 2016 for that man on your screens right now, just talking to his elated crew. He would have thought that's made up for the one that got away in Le Mans when he led on the last lap.
There we go. He's lining him up at the chicane. It's classic Hassan. It's classic Valentino Rossi.
Some really, really good rides in that race. Carol Abraham, seventh. That equals his best ever Premier Class result. That's the way to celebrate. Hoyker monster wheelie.
Just look at the faces of the crowd. Every one of those people in that background stand is smiling and waving. That's what this man has done to this sport. There is Marc Márquez, third place. Some very important World Championship points.
Well, Mark, congratulations, third place here in Assen. A very exciting fight at the end. But what was more difficult, fighting with Cal and Dobby or saving that big slide in the final chicane?
It was difficult all the race. Honestly, in this circuit, we know that we will struggle, will be difficult, and we know the conditions always changing. But in the end, if you say to me that after the race you will be just 11 points behind the first guy, I will sign. So it was really difficult to understand when push, when try to stay there. I had a few warnings, and then I say, okay. It's time to finish in the podium, time to be here, and really happy because in this circuit normally we struggle, so we take a really good podium.
Great. Thanks a lot, Mark. Congratulations.
Yeah, exactly right. 11 points going into the summer break. I mean, that is going to be...
So a few warnings. How many does he need by the end of every corner?
I say there was one very big warning with you. Danilo Petrucci on the podium once again with Dylan.
Well, Danilo, congratulations. Once again, you are on the MotoGP podium. A fantastic race, but tell me, what are your feelings like? You were so close. Were you hoping for the win, but I think there was a bit of frustration maybe with the back marker?
Yeah, I think I prepared all the race, all the last three laps when I saw that we were only me and Vale, and in the last sector I was a little bit faster. But in the last lap, we found Barbara at the last chicane, and in the penultimate lap, Barbara at the last chicane, and in the last lap, I found Rins. No blue flag for the lapped riders, and I lost Valentino, and we arrived almost together on the finish line. So, yeah, I'm happy, but I could win, and I don't know. We fight always with the rule, and... When it counts, no blue flag in the last lap. And anyway, I'm happy. I would like to thank all the team and everyone.
Oh, thanks a lot, Danilo. Congratulations.
It's interesting because, yeah, it was Hector Barbera, wasn't it, on the penultimate lap, and that's where Rossi broke away a bit. And then he was lining up again, and then it was Alex Rins.
And in defence of Alex Rins, obviously no blue flags being waved, so he would not have
exactly
known.
Exactly right.
Although that said, he would have already seen Rossi come through, so he probably should have been expecting... some other of the front runners to be coming through. This was a last lap, crucial podium there. Crucial overtake for Marc Márquez on Cal Crutchlow. Crutchlow missing out on a podium here in Assen by just 0.04 of a second. What a cracking battle that was for third.
Yeah, and the man in fifth place, Dovizioso, has taken over the lead in the World Championship. There he is, number four at the back of the group. Oh, Crutchlow nearly got him on the line.
That's what 0.04 of a second looks like over the finish line in the MotoGP race.
The crowd now wait. He's 38 years old. He just won his 115th Grand Prix. Valentino Rossi with Dylan.
Well, Valentino, it's been a long time since we've seen you on the number one step, but once again, you've chosen Assen as the place to get back to winning ways. I think win number 10 here for you. What is it about this place that just brings out the best?
This place is always special, especially today that you have a lot of people around and the track is fantastic. I'm so happy for me, for my team, because I'm back on the first place after 1 year, more or less, and it was a great race. I'm so happy. Great. The best way. Thanks.
Excellent, Valentino. Congratulations.
That's what the crowd think. Well, that has blown the championship absolutely wide open.
This was a big moment in that race, the contact from Johan Zarco. How lucky was Rossi to stay on there? You can see his left leg was jammed off the foot peg. Not too sure he'd be pretty happy with Zarco's aggression. He was complaining about him in Austin, in Texas. Rossi was running a much wider line. You can see he swept back to the apex. There wasn't any room there, really, for Zarco to have a look. They're just looking there. Probably going to see a big rubber mark. That's courtesy of Johan Zarco. Well, it's rubbed off one of the letters. He's the docker now, not the doctor.
Right, onto the podium they will go. The Italian national anthem will boom out once again over this flat part of Holland. Well, most Holland's flat, but this particular part. Great ride by Cal Crutch. They're probably a bit disappointed he didn't finish on the podium, but he put in a terrific shift at the end there. And it was only Marquez just before the chicane at the Rumshoek that actually got past him to pinch third place, although he nearly got it back as they went across the line.
Still trying to pause for breath here. I mean, she's trying to remember so many things that happened in that race. Confirmation there, the 10th win in Assen in all classes for Valentino Rossi. He did it way back in 1997 on a 125. He did it on a 250 a couple of years later, and that is his 8th Premier class success here. Some young fans there banging on the window to get Rossi's attention. Brilliant. Good bit of sportsmanship there between the two of them.
Yeah, shaking the hands out with Mark Marquez and another chat with Danilo Petrucci. Now onto the podium they've come. 11 points separate the first four riders now in the World Championship. Danilo Petrucci, Mark Marquez, and now the Doctor, 38 years old, his 115th Grand Prix victory, his 10th in Assen. 20 years ago, he arrived here as an 18-year-old and won the 125cc race. Rule him out of championship contention in your peril.
Crew chief Silvano Galbacera then will receive the constructor prize from the sponsor distributors here in Holland. Rossi leading the applause for his Italian crew chief.
In third place, he's the world champion and he's right back in contention. It's going to be Marc Márquez. Yeah, good ride by Márquez. A few warnings, decided. But he just picked off Cal Crutch over some vital points when it really mattered at the end there. He's right back in contention, 11 points down on Dovizioso.
94th podium of his career, he's 55th in the Premier class.
In second place, he really does feel he could have won the race. Not happy about the situation on the penultimate and the last lap. Danilo Petrucci is there once again. His second podium finish in three races.
The 115th time in his career, Valentino Rossi about to take the winner's trophy for the 89th time in his Premier Class career.
105,000 fans that packed the Assen circuit are on their feet. They celebrate one of the truly greats of motorsport. His name, Valentino Rossi.
Thank you.
What else can you say about that man on the top step of the podium here in Assen? I think that was a popular win, Nick.
Yeah. The last four MotoGP races have attracted crowds of 100,000. They just can't stay away when you witness what we've seen this afternoon. 1 week's time would be another legendary venue, the Sachsenring in Germany. 11 points separate the first four riders in the championship after 8 rounds.